Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission System. And this is lecture number 9.1. We are going to discuss the design of speed reducer. In the earlier lecture, we have discussed the design of spur gear, helical gear, bevel gear and worm gear using the PSG design data book. Also, we solved problems in all the four types of gears. Also, we solved a few problems using the Lewis equation and Buckingham equation for calculating various parameters in the gear drive. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the design of speed reducer. So, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to design the speed reducer using the PSG design data book. So, gearbox and speed reducer. So, the terms we are very much familiar because today almost everybody has got a two-wheeler with a four-stroke cycle engine. So, in all the two-wheeler, we have gearbox for changing multiple speeds. And as a mechanical engineering student, you would have worked in the lathe drilling machine in the machine shop. So, there again, you have the experience of changing the speed of the headstock of the lathe and this changing the speed of the spindle speed of the drilling machine using the gearbox arrangement. So, the gearbox is used to produce multiple speeds. So, for a single input speed from a motor, so we will get multiple output speed. Whereas speed reducer is a single stage constant mesh gearbox where we will get only one output speed, reduced output speed comparing with the motor input speed. And the speed reducer also we find in many area, many applications we have. So, the constant mesh gearbox or the speed reducer, they are used in the turbine generator set, rolling mill. In all the applications, we require a constant output speed. Normally, to run the machine, run the application at lower speed than the motor. And the sliding mesh gearbox or multi-speed gearbox, we can change the speed, output speed using the sliding action and the meshing, sliding. And then, because of sliding, the gear will engage, gear will mesh with another gear, so that you will get multiple output speed. Examples are automobile gearbox and the machine tool gearbox. So, these are all very popular. And there are many multi-speed gearbox used in the mechanical engineering. And the speed reducer, so because it is a single speed, output speed reducer, in the earlier type, spur gear design, bevel gear design, helical gear design, herringbone gear design, bevel worm gear design. So, in a single stage, one output speed, one input speed. In single stage, we have designed the same type of arrangement we are going to design. In addition to that, the other parameter for speed reducer that also we have to consider in the discussion. So, select the type of the speed reducer from the power to be transmitted. So, type means depending on the speed ratio, axis position, available space and type of use. So, based on the power, gear ratio, axis position, space available and type of use, we can select a spur gear application, spur gear speed reducer, helical gear speed reducer, herringbone gear speed reducer, bevel gear speed reducer or a worm gear speed reducer depending on all the conditions. Then for low gear ratio, select single reduction. There will be one set of gear, one pinion and one gear, single reduction. Suppose the speed ratio is higher, then you go for two-stage speed reduction. Select bevel gears for intersecting shaft. For silent operation, large reduction, select the worm gear. These are all the guidelines. Select suitable material for the gear and the shaft. Determine the center distance on the basis of surface compressive stress. So, all these point we have discussed earlier in the gear design. In all the gear design, we have calculated the surface stress, we have calculated the center distance, we have calculated the module, and we calculated all the design parameters, bending stress, everything we have calculated. So the same procedure we have to repeat. Determine the center distance on the basis of surface compressive stress. Determine the module by beam strength and fix the suitable number of teeth. Then determine the diameter of the shaft considering the twisting moment and the bending moment. So once the gear design is over, we have to design the shaft. The shaft design you studied in the fifth semester. So you have to consider the twisting moment and the bending moment and calculate the diameter of the shaft. Then determine suitable key for mounting the gears on the shaft. Also suggest suitable fit for fixing the gear. And select suitable bearing for load conditions, maximum speed and the expected life. So the bearing design also you studied in the fifth semester. So from that application you have to design the, from that knowledge you have to design the bearings. Make the shaft stepped or provide collar to prevent the axial displacement of bearing and the gears. Provide suitable clearance between the gears and the walls of the housing and design the casing, the outer cover of the speed reducer, that also we have to design. Then complete the design, provide inspection hole, drain plug and oil level indicator, etc. Then make the new dimensioned sketch of the arrangement. So these are all the steps for designing the speed reducer. So here we have to combine the knowledge of gear design, shaft design, key design, bearing design and the outer casing design. Everything we have to do for a complete design of the speed reducer. And these are all the different types of speed reducer available. So this is the bevel gears per gear combination, two stage speed reduction. So this is warm gear gearbox, single stage speed reduction. This is the again bevel gear, helical gear, bevel gear, helical gear combination for the two stage speed reduction. So these are all the some of the examples of the speed reducer. And this is herringbone arrangement for speed reduction. So herringbone gear speed reducer. And this is the single stage cylindrical gear speed reducer, what is available in the PSG design data book. So all these specifications, we have the gear, shaft, bearing, everything is shown here. We have to design all the component and we have to draw a detailed drawing like this using the dimensions of our calculation, our design. Then this is the two stage cylindrical gear speed reducer. So two stages. So the input shaft and the output shaft, they have two stages, because when you have higher speed reduction, then we have to use the two stages of speed reduction. There is the single stage bevel gear speed reduction. So single stage bevel gear. So when the shafts are intersecting, we have to select the single stage bevel gear for speed reduction. And this is the combination of two stage bevel gear speed reducer. So you look at here, it is a combination of two gears, two types of gear, bevel gear and the spur gear or cylindrical gear. So one bevel gear set and another one is cylindrical gear set. These are all the different types of speed reducer available. So based on the design procedure, you have to design the gear and you have to design other parameter, the shaft design, key design, everything we have to design and you have to prepare a detailed drawing. So in the earlier example, earlier calculations, all these four types of spur gear, helical gear, bevel gear and the worm gear design, some of the examples it is specifically mentioned a speed reducer. So design a bevel gear for speed reducer, design a worm gear for speed reducer. The gear part we have solved earlier. So that is what normally in the university examination, if at all they ask a question, they will ask only question only like that. So here we are not going to calculate, we have the basic knowledge in the fifth semester, we studied the machine design one, we studied the shaft design, we studied the bearing design, key design, everything. But here we are not going to calculate the parameter in the examination point of view. So we just understand what is the procedure for speed reducer design and the problem what we solved earlier, that is sufficient for the speed reducer design. So I stop here. These are all the books I published in the mechanical engineering subject and I upload the video lectures for all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning and to score high marks in the university examination. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me for any clarification on the subject. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the design of multiple speed gearbox. Until then, bye.